Now, how does blockchain and AI connect, and how do you and I capitalize on it? This is some cutting edge, very cutting edge stuff. So stay tuned, and I'm going to embrace yourself for what is to come here. Now, I drive, I go down and cross the bridge, and I had to go check out a place on Steiner, which is over there on Pacific Heights in San Francisco. And I'm just freaking, daydreaming, right? Just daydreaming, like thinking about like where this AI stuff is going and how fast it's moving. Like, and it's hard to comprehend because only 2.5, 3 years ago, I never heard of AI. Really didn't mean anything to me. I never heard of it, but I didn't know what it was. So now it's just exploded in, intensely. The common, and I feel like it's moving so incredibly fast that I gotta run just to stand still and keep up. Now, what I want to give you in the way of value on this channel right now is the insight to where if you're even freaking watching me, okay, you're light years ahead of everybody else. Because here's the deal. I'm gonna share a video. My buddy Josh Reid, political freaking expert, one of the smartest guys, ex-military. He's an ex-military guy, military intelligence guru, and expert on politics. Now, one of the things he talks about is crypto. But what he doesn't mention ever is utility. It's just the same for me, not really exciting. I mean, it's, I hope people get rich off of it, and I do too. Let's all get rich, and that's, dude, that's great. But the real exciting part is the utility, the scalability of blockchain, and the combination of how it's going to integrate into AI and to be first on that. That's what excites me. But let me share some of the insight that he's gonna bring in. I want to cover a little bit more.
So one thing that we have to realize here in the United States of America is we are not like Hong Kong. We're not like Tokyo. We're not like Singapore. We have antiquated infrastructure in this country. Our cities are completely outdated, sitting on 50, 60-year-old technologies. This is a big problem, as this is one of the reasons why 5G rollout took so long and why technological integration into our society has taken so long, is because we have an old country infrastructure. What the Trump administration is doing is they're allowing foreign investment capital, UAE, Qatar, Saudi Arabia. You have SoftBank, Oracle. You have the UK, which I think is good for 200 billion. You have Apple, that's going to do 600 billion. You're talking over $15 trillion of new capital flowing into the United States, particularly for artificial intelligence, medical biosciences, blockchain, and quantum computing. And
All right. Kind of give you a background about how much money he's talking about there, right? I mean, I could just tell you, oh, 15 trillion. Like, that doesn't mean anything to me. But, now you could see where this is. He laid it out. We do know that Apple, we do know these companies are part of it. We've seen these announcements that they're definitely part of it. And they're investing in artificial intelligence, blockchain, these high tech industries like you talking about. Now, another part that's super, super important that he mentions that is not getting any coverage.
There's one methodology that Donald Trump has taken, and people were really confused by this because they didn't understand. It's known as the US Army Detachment 201. All
Two oh
right?
one.
US Army Detachment 201. What is it? US Army Reserve Unit dubbed Detachment 201, also known as the Executive Innovation Corp. Its goal is to integrate top tech executives into military advisory roles to accelerate innovation and modernization. Developed June 13th, 2025, four high-profile tech leaders were directly commissioned as lieutenant colonels in the United States Army.
My
Andrew
God, I didn't know about
Bosworth,
this.
yeah, Andrew Bosworth, Meta CEO, Meta.
Meta.
You have Kevin Weil, OpenAI's chief production officer,
OpenAI.
Bob McGrew, advisor at Thinking Machines, ex-OpenAI researcher,
X
and
OpenAI.
Shyam Sankar, Palantir CTO.
Palantir.
These executives serve part-time as senior advisors for ongoing modernization projects such as AI, VR, human-machine integration, hypersonics, innovation pipelines under the broader Army Transformation Initiative. Now, this is what I want people to see in a more centralized scope. Trump nationalized those companies through the U.S. Army. any way you want to look at it. Those guys now lost various rights under the U.S. Code, under the U.S. Constitution, and now fall under the jurisdiction of the Uniform Code of Military Justice. Their loyalties to the U.S. Constitution.
Doesn't that...
All right, so these guys, all right, which we're talking about, Meta, specifically the CEO of Meta, OpenAI, the CIO, AI companies, Palantir. These companies are now under the military. That means they face military justice should they go against the United States Constitution. What just happened in that military, that Form 201 Act, is that these companies have now been put under the guidance of the military, nationalized in a way. Now, it doesn't scare me at all. What scared me before was rogue Meta company paying off ballots and stuffing ballots, like we know that has already come out in court cases down there in Arizona. With that's what scared the heck out of me. Like, what's going on? Zuckerbucks? Like, that scared me. But now we could see what actually happened. A deal was made. Zuckerberg made a deal. He says, you know what? You're going to face immunity. You apologize, write a letter to Congress. I apologize. And you tell us what happened and who else was involved. And you put your CEO involved in this, and we'll give you immunity. So at this point in time, because you know that information and the information between blockchain connection and AI, now what he's going to tell you next, and this isn't advice, you got to decide on your own, but what he's going to tell you next, a lot of other people's, is invest in crypto, and whatever the Trump administration says, whatever they kind of buy, you know, Trump administration, Donald Trump himself and others, you know, XRP, BTC, and these others, Ethereum. Okay. So they're going to tell you. And dude, you decide what you're going to do. But what nobody will tell you is about scalable utility on chain, the utility of the blockchain with this massive AI innovation, and how that's going to be capitalized on what's called Terra Node. All right, that's happening now. And this AI boom is happening within the next year. We're going to be in a whole different world. It's not even going to be nothing like what we see today. So within 1 year's timeline, we're going to look back and say, those were the good old days, 2025. Man, summer, good old days. We had it chill. We weren't sure what was going to happen. What a world, a different world we're living in now in a year, 1 year. It's going to be a lot different, I'm telling you. And just because you know this information about the original Bitcoin protocol, and how it's the only one that scales, it's the only one that's compliant, it's the only one that has the patents, it's the only one that freaking can possibly absorb adoption up to even 1 billion transactions a second in the coming future, it's the only way. Hit the ones, man. I will see you at the top.